Hey guys, Lytane here, and do you know what really sucks? War. War affects people on a daily basis. The people that are in the war and the people that are left behind. Both people get affected just as easily. And the fact that the media and video games have glorified this with games like Call of Duty and Battlefield as a way to escape and have fun shooting people and stuff, which I don't say is bad necessarily, it's just that they glorify this aspect of war. There aren't too many things that show the harshness of war, especially in video games. That is until a little company made one called This War of Mine, which shows the people left behind during a war zone. And I'm gonna see today if it's worth it. This War of Mine is a game created by 11-bit Studios, which tells the story of the people just trying to survive whilst a war breaks out around them, loosely based around the Siege of Sarajevo in Bosnia that happened in the early 90s. War has been going on and the people left band together in a dilapidated house or apartment in order to survive. They eat and build essentials just to live. The problem though is that someone needs to go out at night and scavenge these supplies. In a war zone, no less, where you will find other people also trying to survive. Bandits, military, and other people populate the area and a few abandoned places as well. But what are you willing to do in order to survive? How far will you go? What lines will you cross? Whose life is worth more? All I know is that war sucks. I am playing the PS4 version of the game, which has an extra bit of content called The Little Ones pre-installed into it, which adds children to an already bleak game. When the game first boots up, you will have two options to play: a custom game, which you can choose everything and anything that you want to do in the game, or a random one, which the game chooses for you. The players that you will control, the areas that you'll get to visit when winter comes, and so on and so forth, are all randomized, and you just have to go and deal with it. Gameplay-wise, there are two major sections of the game. The day period, which has you controlling all of your heroes and setting them out to tasks like crafting or sleeping or something like that. And then the nighttime period, which has you send out one of your people in order to scavenge and loot an area. In both instances, you'll be able to interact with different objects and talk to different people and make decisions. And a lot of decisions are gonna have to be made. In the daytime, your goal is to explore your dwelling and scavenge anything that you can find there. When that's done, you need to start crafting things like beds and a stove if you want to eat and sleep. You also need to talk and play with other characters and give them meds if they are sick or give them bandages if they have been hurt. Sometimes a guest will also knock on your door, either asking for trade or for help. It's all up to you as well if you decide to help or not, and these events are random in each playthrough, which gives it a bit of variety. At night, you select one of your survivors to go scavenging. It's a race against time as you explore the dwellings trying to loot what you think that you will need for the next day. Here, you will need items like lockpicks and shovels in order to get around obstacles, and sometimes you might just run into a person, and they can either be friendly or hostile. Depending on your actions, can also turn somebody friendly into somebody hostile. Now that you've got the basic understanding of how the game plays, I want to get into the very heart of this game, and that is choices. Everything you do in this game is a choice. There are so many out there. If somebody comes to your door, do you help them? Do you give them that last bit of food that you have in order to help a sick child? Or do you deny them because you want to keep that food for yourself in order for you to survive? All of these choices and more are littered throughout the entire game. While scavenging, you may also run into other survivors that are just trying to live. And then what do you do? Do you steal from them? Do you pickpocket them? Do you kill them because your needs are greater than theirs? Or do you just let them live and let them keep their stuff because you understand that everybody is trying to survive here? Every choice that you make will have a different effect on your mental state and the character's mental state as well. By helping people out, everyone stays relatively happy, but by refusing their help or by stealing or killing people, you are affected. Your character can become sad, and then if you keep doing bad things, they can eventually end up broken. This may cause them to lash out or even flee your dwelling, meaning that you have fewer hands in the future. You have to keep them well fed as well, because if you don't, they will die of starvation. the mix of trying to survive coupled with the fact that you're trying to keep your characters healthy and happy and fed is a very tough one. A lot of the places that you will go to also have notes for you to read, and these can range from anything, from a little tip or most of the time to something that is happening in the world around you. They have stuff like somebody's father has died, so then they have buried him in the backyard with his favorite pistol. Now you can go to the backyard and you can dig up him and get his pistol if you so desire. There's also ones where it's like a little girl writing and they have no more food and their parents are missing, and when you go and search the house, there's no one there. What happened to this little girl? Did she survive? Did she run away? Did she find her parents? I don't know, and neither do you. And these things tug at you throughout the entire game. But that might not have the same effect on you as it did with me, especially if you treat this like a video game. If you don't get invested in the survivors or your actions and instead be cold, then it is a very different experience. That honestly happened to me after a few playthroughs. I learned the strategies to maximize my time efficiently, that by the end of the war, I had all the food and materials that I could ever need. Even with this sense of coldness though, I still did fear bandits because they could kill me and I didn't want to die, but aside from that, nothing else really affected me. This leads me on to the Little Ones expansion. Sure, it does add a little bit more depth and a little bit more characterization with the fact that you have to take care of children, but honestly, they don't really contribute that much to the game. They run around, you can control them and all that kinds of stuff, but you can't send them out to scavenge at night because they're children. They can learn certain tasks to do around the house that, you know, you can get them to, say, do the water purification or make them cook meals, but doing this makes them take twice as long as a normal person. You have to keep them healthy and happy, and they take less food, which is good, and they are actually easier to remain happy. But one of the achievements for this game is to make the child broken, which is like, you know, don't feed them, make bad choices in life, and then treat them like crap in order to get them so depressed that they become broken. Then, after that, get them back to being happy, like giving them toys and giving them food and stuff. The fact that the game trivializes the fact that you should make children broken just goes to show that this feels more like a video game after a while of playing. If you do want to go through all of these achievements and stuff, that's totally up to you. But the developers wanted you to, and that just kind of breaks the point of the game where you're supposed to get affected by this and think about war and how bad it is and how it affects people, and then it's just like, hey, for fun, why don't you make a child broken and then bring them back to being happy? Now let's talk about the visuals. The color scheme for this game is mostly brown, black, and gray, but even so, there is quite a lot of depth to this. The characters stand out quite vividly, and the bright white dots let you know what you can interact with in the entire world, which is very handy. The backgrounds feel like paintings, and they have a swirl effect over them as well, which is quite nice and artistic. It's accompanied by some music as well, and although it's nice, I don't think it was memorable. Most of the time, there isn't any kind of music, and it's more ambience to build up the tension and set the mood, which suits the game very well. In my opinion, this War of Mine is worth it. It is a very different take on a war game, and I accept that and I welcome that because we need some more different varieties around the world. The fact that you have to go through this game and make a lot of different moral choices is very, very good. I like the fact that you can randomize the game so it's fresh every time you go through because you don't know what's going to happen, or you can customize it so you can play the game experience that you want. The little problems are the fact that after you've learned how to play the game very well, it becomes very easy, and because of that, less enjoyable. By the time I went through for my platinum run, I had fully understood how to do the game, and it was just a matter of going through the motions until I could get the trophies that I was after. It is not a very difficult game if you figure it out, but when I first played it, it was very, very hard and very taxing and very stressful trying to manage my characters, keep them healthy and happy, and then also trying to explore the world and not die. I didn't know what I was going to need in places and so on and so forth. Because of this variety and because it is quite fun the first couple of times you play through this, I recommend it. I don't recommend playing it too many times because you might turn out like me and become a bit bitter, and not bitter towards the game, but a little bit less into it than what you once were. But I still think that this game is fun and it is very, very well made, and that you should definitely give it a try. So guys, tell me what you thought about this War of Mine. Did you like it or did you hate it? Sorry about the tone of this video being a little bit more sad, depressed, and dark, and more serious than I'm usually used to, because of course the subject matter and the video game subject matter are very serious ones, so I didn't want to treat it with any kind of disrespect. But yeah, let me know what you thought. Did you have the same problem that I did, where if you played the game too many times, it just became too easy and became a bit more of just a video game? You didn't really care and it made you cold, which was kind of the anti-point that the game was trying to make? Or, you know, did it not affect you at all like it affected me or what? Let me know in the comments down below, and don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye! Is a very taxing one. The choices that you make for these characters